Hello students, we will start a unit 2, that is cyber offenses and cyber crime. Technology can be used for both good and bad purposes. People with the tendency to cause damage or carrying out illegal activities will use it for a bad purpose. In unit 1, we all seen hacking, industrial espionage, network intrusions, password sniffing, computer viruses, etc. They are the most commonly occurring crimes that target the computers in day-to-day life. Cyber criminals use internet and www, that is World Wide Web, for illegal activities and to store data, contacts, account information, etc. They will store these all data, contacts, account information, by doing illegal activities with the help of internet and World Wide Web. The criminals take advantage of lack of awareness about cyber crimes and cyber laws among the people who are constantly using information technology for their official purposes or personal purposes. People who commit cyber crimes are known as crackers. Here they have given some technical terms related to cyber offenses and cyber crimes. We will see those. The first one is hacker. A hacker is a person with a strong interest in computers who enjoys learning and experimenting with them. These people are very talented and smart, who understand computers better than others or users. Okay, hacker may be software professional also, or he may commit a cyber crime for illegal activity. Okay, he can do a illegal activity or he can commit a cyber crime against the law. The next one is brute force hacking. It is a technique used to find passwords or encryption keys. Brute force hacking involves trying every possible combination of letters, numbers until the code is broken. Here hacker, what he will do? He will go on entering passwords or encryption keys by guessing. Okay, he will try every combination of letters, numbers, okay, until the password is broken. The next one is cracker. A cracker is a person who breaks into a computers. Crackers should not be confused with the hackers, because hackers may be software professional also. They will do hacking for some office work or organization works. Okay. The term cracker is usually connected to the computer criminals. Always cracker will do illegal activity or he will do computer criminals. Okay, but hacker may be software professional. He may do hacking for a good purpose also. Next one is cracking. It is the act of breaking into computers. Cracking is a popular and growing subject on the internet. Okay, nowadays the cracking becomes more famous on the internet. Okay, he will break the computers. For example, password cracking. Okay, many sites provide ready-made programs to crack the computers. Some of these programs contain dictionaries for guessing passwords. Okay. Ready-made programs may be viruses, Trojan horses, worms, like that. Cracker tools. Okay, these are the programs used to break into computers. Cracker tools are widely distributed on the internet. Okay, these tools include programs like Trojans, worms, viruses. Okay, we can call them as a cracker tools. These are the programs used to break into a computers. Phishing. This is the notorious art of breaking into communication system. Phishing sites are popular among crackers and other criminals. Okay, here cyber criminals will use mobile phones to commit a cyber crimes. Next is war dialer. It is a program that automatically dials phone numbers looking for computers on the other end. Okay, it is a program. It automatically dials the phone numbers and it will look for computers on the other end. Suppose I am installed this war dialer program in my computer. It will automatically go on dialing phone numbers. Then suppose it get a one phone number which is correct one on the other end, then he can attack on that computer. It makes a complete list of phone numbers so that the hacker can call back and try to break in. Okay. Usually networks are not adequately protected. So hackers typically search for vulnerabilities like misconfigured systems, application servers with the well-known software tools designed to take advantage of flaw in computer. Means something error or something failure in a computer, they will make use of it. The cyber criminals will make use of it, and always hackers search for such vulnerabilities. The next is categories of cyber crime. These are categorized based on 2 points. The first one is target of time. The second one is crime occurs as a single event or a series of events. The first category is crimes targeted at individuals. Here, cyber criminals' goal is to make use of human weakness such as a greed. These crimes include financial frauds, sale of non-existent or stolen items, child pornography, copyright violation, harassment. The second one is crimes targeted at property. This includes stealing mobile phones, laptops, PDAs, removable devices, and transmitting harmful programs which will disturb the functions of a system. It may wipe out the data from a hard disk. It may erase the data from a hard disk of a computer. The next category is crimes targeted at organizations. Okay, here it will come that cyber terrorism. Okay, it is the one of the crime against a organization. Here attacker uses computer tools and internet to usually attack on citizens of a particular country by stealing the private information of those citizens and also damage the files or programs of their systems by planting malicious programs or viruses, worms, like that. Next is single event of a cyber crime. Here user may click on link unknowingly that opens an attachment which contains a viruses. The next one is series of events. Okay, here attacker interacting with the victims by using a mobile phone. Once he get a mobile phone number of that victim, he make use of it and he start harassing them by calling. Okay, again and again. Thank you.